Good morning, students. Today we are going to revise chapter number 4, Agriculture. In this video, we are going to cover the topics like types of farming, cropping pattern, and major crops. Let's begin. Primitive subsistence farming. It is practiced on small patches of land with the help of primitive tools like hoe, dao, and digging sticks. Okay, and it is carried out with the help of family or community labor. Here you can see the image of hoe and dao. Okay, so it is quite clear, students, that primitive subsistence farming is practiced on small patches of land with the help of primitive tools and with the help of family or community labor. Land productivity is low. Students, do you know why is the land productivity low in primitive subsistence farming? Yes, you are right. Because farmers don't use fertilizers or any other modern inputs. Hence, land productivity is low in primitive subsistence farming. This type of farming depends on monsoon. It is a slash and burn agriculture. Now let us learn more about slash and burn agriculture. Okay. Farmers clear a patch of land and produce cereals and other food crops to sustain their family. When the soil fertility decreases, the farmers shift and clear a fresh patch of land for cultivation. This type of shifting allows nature to replenish the fertility of the soil. So I hope you have understood about slash and burn farming. It is known as zooming in northeastern states. It is known by different names in different parts of the country. Now let us learn about intensive subsistence farming. This type of farming is practiced in areas of high population pressure on land. So where is intensive subsistence farming practiced? Yes, intensive subsistence farming is practiced in areas of high population pressure on land. It is labor intensive farming. Now what do you mean by labor intensive farming? Labor intensive farming requires a large amount of labor. Okay, so intensive subsistence farming is carried out in areas of high population pressure on land. It is labor intensive farming where high doses of biochemical inputs and irrigation are used for higher production. Okay, now let us move on to commercial farming. This type of farming uses higher doses of modern inputs such as high yielding variety seeds, chemical fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides to obtain higher productivity. So to obtain higher productivity, modern inputs like HYV seeds, chemical fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides are used in farming. Is that clear, students? Now let us learn about plantation. Okay, it is a type of commercial farming. In this type of farming, a single crop is grown on a large area. Plantations cover large tracts of land using capital intensive inputs with the help of migrant laborers. All the produce is used as raw material in industries. So let us revise once again. Plantation, it's a type of commercial farming. Okay. In this type of farming, a single crop is grown on a large area. Plantations cover large tracts of land using capital intensive inputs with the help of migrant laborers. All the produce is used as raw material in industries. For example, tea, coffee, rubber, sugarcane, banana. Now let us view the images. Okay, here you can see tea and coffee plantations, rubber and sugarcane plantation. Here in this image you can see banana plantation. Okay.
Now let us learn about cropping pattern. India has three cropping seasons: Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. Okay, now let us learn more about these. Rabi. Rabi crops are sown in winter from October to December and harvested in summer from April to June. Important Rabi crops are wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. Once again we will revise. Sowing season, winter from October to December. Harvesting season, summer from April to June. Important Rabi crops, wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. I hope it is clear. Now let us talk about Kharif. Okay, Kharif crops are grown with the onset of the rainy season, that is beginning of the rainy season. Okay, and harvested in the month of September, October. Important Kharif crops are paddy, maize, jawar, bajra, tur, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soya bean. We will revise once again. Kharif, sowing season, onset of the rainy season. Harvesting season, September, October. Important Kharif crops, paddy, maize, jawar, bajra, tur, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soya bean. I hope you have understood this. Now let us learn about Zaid. Okay, in between the Rabi and the Kharif seasons, there is the short season during the summer months, which is known as the Zaid season. Okay, so in between the Rabi and Kharif season, there is a short season during the summer months known as the Zaid season. Now let us learn more about Zaid crops. Okay, some of the crops produced during Zaid are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and fodder crops. Okay, I hope you will remember this. Now we are going to learn about major crops grown in India. Okay, rice, wheat, millets, pulses, tea, coffee, sugarcane, oilseeds, cotton, jute, etc. Today, okay, we will cover rice and wheat. The remaining ones we will cover in our next video. So let's start with rice. Rice, it is a staple food crop of a majority of the people in India. Isn't it, students? Rice is a very important food crop of a majority of the people in India. It is a Kharif crop. Requires high temperature, about 25 degrees Celsius. So you need to remember this. Rice require high temperature, that is about 25 degrees Celsius, and high humidity with annual rainfall about 100 centimeter. Now you will ask, Miss, what about the regions where there is less rainfall? So there also rice can be grown with the help of irrigation. Okay. India is the second largest producer of rice in the world after China. So the first largest producer of rice in the world is China. And our country India, it is the second largest producer of rice. Okay. Rice is grown in the plains of North and Northeastern India, coastal areas and the deltaic regions. Here in this map you can see. Okay. Now, let us talk about wheat. Wheat. Wheat is a Rabi crop. It is the second most important cereal crop and the main food crop in the north and northwestern part of the country. So wheat is a Rabi crop. It is the second most important cereal crop and the main food crop in the north and the northwestern part of our country. Wheat requires a cool growing season and bright sunshine at the time of ripening. You need to remember this, students. Wheat requires a cool growing season and bright sunshine at the time of ripening. It requires 50 to 75 centimeter of annual rainfall, evenly distributed over the growing season. Once again, wheat requires 50 to 75 centimeter of annual rainfall, evenly distributed over the growing season. Now let us see the two main important wheat growing zones in India. The Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwest and black soil region of the Deccan are the two main wheat growing zones in India. Is that clear, students? Now it's time for quiz. Whatever we have learnt, I'm going to ask you some questions. I hope you all are ready to answer. Which of the following crops are grown with the onset of monsoon and are harvested in the months of September, October? Yes. Which is the correct answer? Once again, I will repeat the question for you. Which of the following crops are grown with the onset of monsoon and are harvested in the months of September, October? Yes, the correct answer is option B, Kharif. Okay, Kharif crops are grown with the onset of monsoon and are harvested in the months of September, October. Very good. Let us move on to the next question. Slash and burn agriculture is a option A, shifting cultivation, option B, intensive agriculture, option C, commercial agriculture, option D, none of these. Yes, students, which is the correct answer? Yes, you are right. It is option A, shifting cultivation. Slash and burn agriculture is a shifting cultivation. Very good. Now, let us move on to the next question. Intensive subsistence farming is practiced in areas of option A, high population, option B, low population, option C, deserts, option D, thick forests. Yes, which is the correct answer? Once again, I will repeat the question. Intensive subsistence farming is practiced in areas of option A, high population, option B, low population, option C, deserts, option D, thick forests. Yes, you are right. The correct answer is option A, high population. Intensive subsistence farming is practiced in areas of high population. Very good. Let us move on to the next question. Students, here you need to categorize the following crops as Rabi and Zaid crops. Okay. Wheat, watermelon, cucumber, peas, mustard, muskmelon. Today you have learnt about Rabi and Zaid crops, right? So I hope you will be able to categorize the following crops as Rabi and Zaid crops. Are you ready with the answer? Come on, let's view the answer. Yes, your answer is right. Wheat, mustard, peas are Rabi crops. Watermelon, cucumber, muskmelon are Zaid crops. Very good. Well done, students. Here is one more question for you. Complete the following table.
okay? Crop, annual rainfall, cropping season. So here the crop given is rice. You need to find out the annual rainfall required for the growth of rice as well as the cropping season of rice.
I hope you are ready with the answer. Let us view the answer. Annual rainfall required for rice to grow is above 100 cm and the cropping season of rice is kharif. Okay, it is grown in kharif season. Well done, students.
Now let us do a short recap. Today we have learnt about types of farming, cropping pattern as well as major crops. We have covered rice and wheat, right? The remaining major crops we will be covering in our next video. Okay, I want you all to read the textbook thoroughly. I hope you have enjoyed today's session. Meet you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.